next, we've got Deña Mitchell. She lives in South Chicago, and she's graduating from Whitney M. Young Magnet High School, where she was on the track and field team and a co-captain of the shot putters. She's also a Chicago Scholars Ambassador. Deña, hey.
Hi, my name is Deña, and the title of my story is Oops, She Knows. I was a sneaky kid, like super sneaky. Like going down into a forbidden basement to spy on a forbidden person, to see something my young eyes should never see, sneak. Like being home alone and reading something my young mind would never understand, sneaky. There was this one time when nobody was a mouse, but maybe a spider, a tiny mouse scurrying to the deepest corner of the basement, hiding from an imaginary foe. It was quiet, and I was reading. I don't remember what provoked me to be sneaky this time. Probably the intrigue of the things I found the last time. Pictures, hidden money, jewelry, and one forbidden item I dare not name. But maybe it was deeper than that. Maybe it was because of the days away and nights that followed when I was alone until school the next day. Perhaps my subconscious knew about the secrets and wanted to know. Because when I went snooping, it was most definitely for something bad. And what I found wasn't necessarily bad because I didn't understand it. I was probably in around fourth grade when I read it then. It was my mom's diary or journal, whatever you want to call it. There were only a few pages filled to the brim with the emotions of a shattering heart that was only breaking because of the sense called women's intuition. I was a smart kid, knowing that in fourth grade. And what I also knew is that a mother knows, and that a mother knows she knows, even when she doesn't know she knows. See, in the middle of one of those few pages in this diary or journal, she wrote an extended version of having your cake and eating it too. I read it back a million times, the page, the entry, trying to use something a fourth grader should know about, context clues. But cake? I was an intrigued, questioning fourth grader, now stumped. I started thinking about ways to ask anyone what this meant. For me then, even now, it wouldn't be totally odd for me to ask a question like that. But I knew I couldn't just go up to my mom and straight up ask what it meant. A death sentence at best. I spent the next few days pondering about what or how I could ask my mom what this meant. And I already said I was clever, so I made a plan. After some hard thinking, I decided, one day, when I get in the car, I'll just say casually, what does it mean to have your cake and eat it too? There's a very popular Katy Perry song always playing on the radio, with the feature of some rapper. And guess what? He said those exact words. So that was my plan. I walked out of the house to the car and straight up asked. But I already told you about mother's intuition. She didn't fold. I could tell that she was questioning where I got that from. She gave me that little side eye, put her eyes back on the road, and in an innocent tone that knew she was about to match my footsteps, and stopped me in my tracks asked, where'd you hear that from? Thank you, Katie, for saving my butt in fourth grade. My mom told me that it meant when someone wants something, two things that are incompatible, something they can't have because they just don't go. But see, little me still didn't understand what was going on. It was a weird expression, and I was still wondering why it was about cake. I probably asked a million questions on that car ride. I still didn't get the answer I was looking for. None of my mother's answers answered the questions on the surface of my subconscious mind. But perhaps I was never meant to have understood what it meant to be indecisive, because I am. Or perhaps I was never meant to understand it that day, so I could know what it's like to question, even if all the answers are right in front of you. Thank you.
Yay! Yay! congrats.
That's awesome. Thank you.